let's come to the three different kinds of matrices we can have, that is semi-definite, positive definite, and negative definite. So we know that the stiffness matrix is a positive definite matrix, and we were getting the result of stiffness matrix multiplied by, in this form, were equal to the work done or some kind of energy. So now let's come to semi-definite. Let's start with the positive definite. So positive definite matrix means X transpose into K into X is going to be greater than zero for all values of X. So that means for all values of X. So for all is the important term over here, for all. Now let's come to semi-definite. So it means that X transpose KX is equal to zero for any, or at least for any value of X, or for at least one value of X. At least one value of X. And for negative definite, this X transpose KX is less than zero for at least one value of X. Again, at least one value of X, okay? So now let's go to more mathematical side of that, which will help us to relate it to the physical understanding of this type of numbers, because these are numbers now. So let's take X as XY, K as ABCD, and X we know as XY. So we have found the value, and we know that X and Y are two components of vector. There we can convert it to X1, X2. Maybe we can write anything. So we have two independent things, and we have one dependent. Two independent things are X1 and X2. And the dependent is that the whole value which we are getting, the whole value of X transpose KX. So we can make some 3D graph out of this, where X and Y are two unknowns, and X, X3 or Z is the known value, and Z is equal to AX square plus 2BXY plus CY square. So we have drawn it over here. So let's start with understanding the positive definite system. So this is always going to be positive, as we know. So this is how a curve can look like. This is one of the representation for the positive definite system. And these are X, Y values, and this is X transpose KX. And this can be understood as a stable equilibrium with physics point of view. That means that if I have a cone, let's take a surface, and if I have a cone and I'm placing the cone on its lateral surface area, then it can move and it can rotate on its lateral surface area if I'm going to give a force, and in any condition, it will go at some position, it will stop over there, it will be stable at all positions. Then let's come to a semi-definite system. The positive definite system will be the cone when it is placed on its circular portion. So if I have a cone and I'm placing like this, and if I'm going to rotate it somewhere, disturb it, it will come back to its original point. So when the circular portion of the cone is placed on the surface. Now we come to the semi-definite system. So it can be represented by some complex topological surface, which I cannot draw very easily on 2D plane. But you can understand that it is some set of x, y values where x transpose kx is zero. So there is some surface, some line, which is exactly placed on that x, y plane. So when even with a displacement, even if I'm going to provide some disturbance to the system at newer point, wherever the system is going to land, the potential energy is going to remain the same which was earlier before the disturbance. So the potential energy remains same. It is not going to have any new motion to it. So it can be understood at some rigid body motion, which we have seen in 2 degrees of freedom system for railway wagon, when they were getting locked and there was a rigid body motion. And for physics point of view, we can understand this as a neutral equilibrium, where I said that if I place the cone and it is like this in first, and if I'm going to give some force and it is going to rotate, it will be in some new position, but at that position also it is going to have some stable equilibrium. And so it is said as neutral equilibrium. Now let's come to unstable equilibrium. So this is how it is going to be. So this is also very complex, and the surface can be said as some kind of saddle surface. And this is negative definite system. So this is the state where disturbance leads to decrease in potential energy. So one of the system can be buckling, where we are going to give some compressive force to the beam and till one point it will absorb all the energy, and after some point, that is this point, this is the deflection delta. So after that point, it is going to break apart, and from in between somewhere where the highest energy was there, it will break apart and we have buckling. And from the physics point of view, we can understand it as an unstable equilibrium. So if we have pushed placed the point cone on the tip of the cone on the surface, and if I'm going to give a very slight disturbance, it is going to lie down on its lateral surface area. So this means that it is going to go on some stable point. So that means it has decreased its potential energy, and now the new potential energy is lower than the initial energy. That means it is a more stable point for that system. So we end over here. We have understood the three different kinds of numbers, that is semi-definite, positive definite, and negative definite. In the next video, we'll start with understanding the mass matrix. Okay, we'll stop over here. Thank you.